What's going on, guys? It's Simo here at YCS London, and who are we with?
Herman Hansen.
And what did you do?
I got top 16 with my Thunder Dragon Link Danger deck, I guess.
And so why did you decide to play this for the event?
I wanted to have fun. So I made this deck at Saturday 2 a.m. And 4 hours later I had to register because I couldn't get here on Friday.
Sure.
So I had 4 hours of sleep comboing people. It was really nice. Like, the idea is the same as my European Championship deck I got the top 4 with and got the Worlds with. So, yeah.
Sure.
Let's get into it. So, start off with 3 Draconet. This card is busted. Please give it an ultimate Konami. I just want to rarity bump it. But even if this gets hand trapped, it's a Cybers, which is like kind of a unique type. So you can make a Curious with it really easily and dangerous. And Curious in this deck like solves every hand. So, Garnets. This isn't nearly as good to draw as it was at Euros because you have less level 3 dangers. You only have 4 of them compared to 6 back then, so it's not like nearly as consistent. So all of these are like really bad to draw, but you need to play them. For the Thunder Dragon engine, 3 OG, 3 Dark, 3 Roar, Double Hawk and 1 Duo. The idea was that like all the Thunder Dragons are like really good. Every hand where you don't have access to Roar or Dark, which you either hard open them or like you draw into dangers, you banish them with like Allure and Melody, you can discard them or like just Curious them. They're like really good, and I didn't ever want to run out of these Thunders, so I decided to max on them.
Right.
For dangers, double Yakalo, double Nessie, double Tsuchinoko, double Mothman, and one of each. I wanted the utility to search of the Nessie, and I always wanted to be able to summon one level 8 from the deck with Yakalo, because I play Titanic, and all of these were really good. The best card?
Yes! So talk about this.
Yeah, so now you have access to 7 copies of Levenir each game. So you summon Levenir 2 to 3 times per turn until your opponent is out of cards.
So what does it do for people who don't know? Since it's still relatively new.
So this card, you can send dragons from hand or field to the grave to add a dragon with the same level. So you can send this to add Collapse Serpent, Wyvern Buster or itself, which actually comes up. Because if you already have Collapse Serpent or Wyvern Buster and you want to use this effect, you can search a new one, so you have Ravine, discard fodder, and in the combo you can banish it, you add back Levenir, and then you pistol summon it back. So next turn you can also add back Levenir. So this deck is basically as Levenir spam, and it works really nice. you summon this of LP quite a lot. Also, opening 2 dangers and safe earth is hand loop for 2 with Apollosa for 2 and Colossus and Titanic Galaxy with like this still in grave. So next turn you just add back Levenir and banish all your Thunder Dragons again and your opponent loses.
Wow.
So it's like immune to Sphere Mode and the other dragons. I play this now because I think it's important that you hand loop Orcas to like as few cards as possible, because the deck is like really scary because they don't lose the Colossus. So the way you win against Orcas is you make the Titanic and IP, and you make Harbinger. Yeah. So you just go Unicorn on their turn. Also, this can't get tributed, so even if they like Nibiru you, they have to Nibiru you on Curious plus Levenir, or Curious plus a Danger, or Curious plus Wyvern Buster, or Curious plus Collapse Serpent, or like anything like that. And then you can add back with Curious, so it's really bad to ever Nibiru this deck. You don't want to do that, because it just does nothing. And if you don't do it at that time, you just make a Palooza, and then you can't get Nibiru. So it's immune to Nibiru, and this card can't be tributed. And power spells. I play this now because it's less Salamangreat, so this card resolves every time. It's insane. And power spells and energy requirements. If you open just Seifert and the Thunder Dragon Roar or Thunder Dragon Dark. You can go Seifert at Collapse Serpent and make Pisty, and then you summon the Wyvern Buster with the search of Collapse Serpent and make Romulus, search this, and then you can discard the Thunder Dragon Dark or Thunder Dragon Roar of this to send Levenir from your deck to the grave, and then you can Seifert back the Levenir. Quite insane. Side deck. Best card of the side deck. I think it's insane. Anger Tops. This was one of the cards I was iffy on, because I didn't know if I wanted to side it. I wanted cards specifically against Guru, because I think Guru is a really solid deck with Voltron at one. But I just never brought it in, it was really bad all day. Twin Twister. I played against one backdoor deck the entire tournament, so this came in once. This is the best card, because Thunder Dragon against this deck goes Apollosa, Titan, Colossus, and Pendulum has to go into Zephranu, and not everyone plays Zephranu. And if you play against Mirror, this is like the best card against this deck, because it just negates everything and they can't respond to it, and then you Levenir and remove and then Guardian combo and you kill them. Well, like, not kill them, because take no damage, but yeah, it's really good, the best card. And three impermanents against the Mirror and against Orcast and against Salamangreat, because it prevents Dweller. Extra deck. You make this with the Draconet combo. You make this in every turn 1 combo where you go Titanic to redirect attacks so they can't ever kill Apollo, and Apollo and Colossus with Seifert, add back Levenir, and next turn just kill them. Colossus. God Dragons. You don't need Augur Pain, it's like, it's a useless ban, I think. Because you wouldn't have space to play Augur Pain anyway. Romulus, because you want to remove these, because ours are locked into dragons. See, in some hands, where you clog with dragon cards, you make this and then you tribute over this with Dragon Roar or Dragon Dark, and that gets your engine started. And in some brick hands, you need to make this to play around Lancia, because every deck like really struggles to play around this card. IP. This is my generic link 2 of choice. It's not much else to say. Against Orcast, you make it under Apollo, because Colossus is kind of useless. And then next, in their turn, you summon Unicorn. Phoenix. This deck is actually a curious deck, by the way. Apollo, sorry, yeah. In the Draconet combo, you go IP in the extra monster zone, and then you make all your monsters under it into Saryuya. So this is needed for the Draconet combo, but outside the Draconet combo, you like, you can always fix your hand with Curious. You never actually need this, so this could be cuttable, but I think it's very nice for Draconet, because if you don't open another extended, you can't make this with Draconet. And Sword, broken.
Can you show us like a basic combo real quick?
I can show you, let's say, Seifert and summoning two dangers.
Sure.
You summon two dangers, you summon Seifert, send Seifert. Summon Collapse. Make all three into Curious, or shelling one Curious, shelling two Collab. So Collab Servant at Wyvern Buster. Curious sends the Dragon Roar. And then you mill three cards of Curious, but that's like kind of irrelevant. It just gives you extra fodder for Levenir later. And you summon this to vanish Roar. And Roar special summon Stark. Make these two into Apollosa, and with this you search the Dragon Hawk. Make this och inte LP. Then you can LP summon Brothar, and you discard a card from your hand to make this. Pisty. And you add back to the, you add 11 with this. So you pisty back this. Make these two. You go into Romulus. Use effect of Romulus, which gets you into Ravine. You activate Ravine. You discard a card. You send Diabolos. So now you have access to both Livinir and Diabolos. And then you use Hawk. You summon back the Roar. You tribute. You make Colossus. And now you get to summon the Diabolos. Then you make these two. Into Nightmare Unicorn. This is a dark monster. You can also make IP. But it depends on the matchup. If you know against Thunder, you would rather waste the IP. But if you don't know like the matchup, I think you'd rather summon this. And tribute this for Diabolos. And then you summon the Levin you researched. Banishing, it doesn't really matter. And then make these two. Into Titanic. And this board is fully immune to Super Poly because there's nothing you can possibly Super Poly into. And your opponent has lost two cards. And yeah, no deck breaks this ever.
That's awesome. So cool. Any shoutouts?
Yeah, I wanna shout out my team, my family, my friends. And I wanna shout out Simon Wang for making this deck with me.
That's awesome. Cool. Thanks so much, Herman. Appreciate it.